Now, you reckon you can talk him into it?
Of course you can. You can tell he's got the hots for you, eh, Roach?
Well, I'll do me best.
I've never been out in the bay before.
Hey, me neither. What are we going to do about the screws?
We're only going to have to worry about two when we get back.
Jeez, right?
You're nuts, you know. You'll go down 20 years doing out a screw.
It'll be worth it.
Well, Nance won't be in it.
Nance is not going to know, right?
Right.
Yeah.
You just tell her what we're going to tell Nick, OK? A nice, fun spin on the water.
Can I spin the wheel again tomorrow?
Of course you can. But there's something else I want you to do tomorrow.
Yeah?
Vicky will stay with you. And she'll have to help out sometimes. So you spin, but you let her read where the ball lands, all right?
Why?
Because she's got a very special way of stopping the wheel so we make more money.
What the hell are you doing?
No worries, just testing the engine.
Look, what I'm saying is Merle's small bait. I can set it up so that you catch a whole group of them actually gambling. Now, wouldn't that look better on your record than just catching a girl who doesn't even know what it's about?
Are you going to tell me who's running this little racket?
Do you need to know? The point is, you will have broken another racket. Let the governor worry about that. You can just sit back and take the glory.
There's no harm done, is there?
I'm sure the governor will cancel the whole scheme when she hears about this.
Only if someone tells her.
I'll be giving her a full report when we get back.
Well, what's the problem? There are three officers and only four women. It's not as if they're going to escape, unless they've learned how to walk on water.
Warner is a security risk. Now, those prisoners talked him into this. They could be planning anything.
Fresh air and sunshine. That's half the point of coming out on work experience. To give them a break.
Oh, give them an inch and they walk all over you. You've got a lot to learn, Jackson. Never let a civilian interfere with prisoner security.
How long do you reckon it'll take to get the engine tested?
She's got a full head of steam up. Reckon it should take half an hour. Real shame, isn't it?
Talk about being sent down the river, eh, Nat?
Yes, you will be, but 20 years ago, I'll count.
With your words, Miss, the man's got to run his engine.
I know you too well, Rita.
Come on, there's nothing wrong with a joyride. Why don't you relax and enjoy yourself?
Why don't we relax together? Then I can keep an eye on you.
Hey, guess what I found? Some fishing gear.
Oh, river lunch. I'll have a bit of flake.
You got any bait?
Oh. We could use the freak. The sharks will eat anything.
Hey, they wouldn't get their teeth into her. Hey, I've got some salami I pinched off Mervyn. Hey, do you reckon the fish would like that?
We could try, I suppose, as long as the officers don't see us.
Oh, geez, here comes Ferguson. I'm nicking off.
Right. Who let the mooring ropes go at the wharf?
We were only taking orders from Captain Meek.
I give the orders around here, not Mr. Warner. All right, well, don't stand around here. Start washing the deck and polishing that brass.
Aye, aye, Captain Bligh.
Oh, watch it, will you?
Excuse me? Can't you clean in here some other time?
I've got to stick to my timetable. If I've got my round done 10 minutes earlier, I don't wear out the mop so fast.
Are you for real?
And I've got to give the rec room an extra clean in case we have the games.
Well, what do you mean in case? Captain Meek are going to make a killing today. I can feel it in my bones.
But if the governor found out...
The governor isn't going to find out, is she?
What's going on? The screw's got wind of this.
Of course not. Anyway, you saw what happened when Adams almost caught us last time. What could be more innocent than a few games? No money's changing hands.
Then what's Merle going on about?
Just being cautious like we all should be.
But when Mr. Adams...
We'll just forget about the casino now, right? Get back to work.
There's no way to talk to your partner.
You're not my partner. You're lucky just to be working for me, so if I were you, I wouldn't go pushing my luck too far, or I'll find someone else. Understood?
Where's the bloody music?
G'day.
You rat!
Groovy choice of music.
Oh, why are you supposed to get anything decent on that thing?
Oh, rock a reggae, Binnin.
Sounds better.
Oh, I know a bit about music, do you?
Yeah, even play myself. Your mum used to make me take piano lessons till I was 12. Haven't played much since. Still have a blast on the mouth organ every now and then.
Blows up?
Great. Reckon you could give me a lesson?
Of course. Better make sure that officer doesn't find out, though. She'll have you mopping and playing at the same time.
Ah, Fergus won't get it every day.
Must be hard taking orders from a nutcase like that. Well, the Navy wasn't that bad. At least we're never locked in.
Yeah. I, got 6 months. Feeling like a lifetime. Anyway, who's up there steering while you're down here yakking?
One of the best sailors the Navy ever lost.
Work experience. How about let me drive this thing?
I've already had my quota of trouble for the day, thank you.
Oh, go on. I won't run into anything out here.
Haven't you got any other work to do? You've been cleaning that thing for the last 10 minutes.
Oh, I like it up here. Smell of the sea and stuff. Hey, what was it like being in the Navy?
Great. Oh, well, sort of. I like some of the travelling and some of the mates I met.
Hey, is it true what they say about sailors having a bird in every port?
Wishful thinking. And don't think you can con me into letting you have a steer by sweet-talking me about the Navy.
I never was.
All right, Jenkins, get down and help the others clean the deck.
Oh, but Mr. Warner told me to clean all this stuff.
Mr. Warner is not in charge of your security, Jenkins. I am.
But he is in charge of the renovations. Actually, while we're at sea, he's in charge of everything.
We will see about that, Mr. Jackson.
Better give this another polish. What do you reckon?
So you're playing a tune already?
I reckon it'd take me ages to play this kind of tune.
I could teach you the basics in a couple of days, but I reckon you've got a real talent for it.
You mean it?
Yeah, you could take the harp back to Wentworth at night. We'll have to practice that.
How charming. You can practice by working on deck with the others.
I have been working. What do you reckon all this is?
Don't be insolent. I want a word with you, Mr. Warner.
She's been doing just fine.
Sort of strange way to test the engines. How long before we get back to the wharf?
I don't know. It could be half an hour by the time I adjust the valves.
I see. I doubt that we will require your boat after today. And in the meantime, you will consult with me before allocating work to the women.
Doesn't seem worth bothering.
It's a security matter, Mr. Warner. I don't have to remind you that I'm in charge here.
While we're at sea, I'm in charge. And before you start handing out orders, make sure you consult me first.
If I smuggle it back to prison.
I'd love to see the look on the screw's faces if they caught it on you.
Look, would you distract me, Stout? I want to throw the line out again.
Yeah, sure.
You did that on purpose.
Oh, she'll be all right. You better go get the freak. I've got a little surprise for her.
Fallen overboard. I don't know if she can swim.
Take the wheel and keep it straight. Don't turn left, I tell you.
But I don't know
how to do it. Quickly, otherwise she'd drown.
I threw the lifebuoy in after her, but she hasn't grabbed it yet. Do something.
Where's
quick.
Nick?
He's in the cabin.
Get him down here straight away. Tell him to turn the boat and pick us up.
Right.
Are you crazy?
Two down, one to go.
Oh, I would have done a you two have been scared to run her over.
You did fine, Alice.
She's going to be okay?
Sure. Marty's a good swimmer.
Jeez, the governor will pull the plug on us when she hears about this.
You can bet the captain will have something to say, too.
I was having such a good time.
Damn. Now what the hell's happening?
Hey, are we out of gas?
No, likely. We'll run on steam. Hold on to this again. I'll take a look at it.
Oh, jeez. Will I keep going straight or what? The engine stopped.
Is this some sort of practical joke?
Not when there's people overboard. Excuse me, I've got to see what's going on down below.
Oh, I do hope they make it.
Steam engines for you. Give me internal combustion any day. Oh, you missed all the fun.
What are they doing over there?
Look, we're drifting further away from shore.
Get below the three if you're gone. I didn't know you could swim so well.
Neither did I.
It looks like they've stopped out in the channel.
I hope I can go.
Nah, that'll be all right. Mick's an experienced sailor.
Come on, let's catch our breath.
Then we'll go and find a telephone box.
Oh, good, I can do with the rest.
We can
get it all up.
Come on, ladies, roll up, place your bets.
Can I have a spin now?
In a minute, Mel, the bank's on a winning
streak. Oh, catch a yakking and spin the bloody thing.
Just a couple more bets and we'll be ready to roll.
You never knit that thing all day.
Lexi, I have to keep going until I get it finished. We've got the cot to paint, we've got to go through all those clothes they gave me, and we've got so much to do.
The only thing I want to do is win on this thing. It's dead set against me today. Come on, spin the bloody thing, will you?
All right, ladies, bets are closed.
Oh, how can I concentrate with you clacking them chopsticks?
Round and round and round she goes, and where she stops, nobody knows. Number. Oh!
Well, 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 table wins again. It's the third time we've had zero in 20 minutes. Put Merle back on.
Luck of the game, ladies. Pick another number and you like my change.
Stuffed if I'm playing anymore. I reckon it's rigged.
Oh, Lexi, stop being such a bad sport.
I think I'll go and have a game of cards.
I'll tell you what. Let's change spinners and I'll give you all a free bet just to show you everything's on the level. Merle, you take over the wheel. Vicky, come and deal blackjack for a while.
I want to win my money back from Adams before he comes looking for me. He
doesn't even know we're gone. Besides, I'm here to look after you.
I have that looking after my luck as well, eh?
I'll put you back on when things have quietened down a bit. Make sure you let a couple win every now and then, but don't go too far.
Well, just keep Patterson away from the card table. She's too good for me.
I can't close it. They'll get suspicious.
Okay, well, just make sure Merle hangs around, all right?
Don't keep the ladies waiting, Merle. I'll just go and check on that net.
Little silver ball, Merle. Coward.
Everything quiet out here?
Adams was cruising around, but he didn't come down this way.
Good. I'm just off to the toilet. Keep on your toes.
When can I have a bet?
Soon. I'll get Mildred with you. Look, here. On the house.
Thanks, Kath.
Don't scare me like that.
I've been waiting for you.
Well, we can't talk here.
I can't wait all day. The others are getting suspicious.
Not yet. I have to move a few things first.
Getting ready for the self-search, are we? You don't miss a trick.
I can't afford to.
I can't afford any slip-ups either. Get rid of the net.
Sorry, that's up to you. They'll get suspicious if I do it.
But she's already seen me once.
I'm sure you're clever enough to think of something. Unless, of course, you want to change your mind and forget about the rake.
No way. I'll make recruit of the year out of this one.
Fine. But you don't make a move until I give the signal.
No point in putting the anchor out, Miss Ferguson. We're in the channel. Wouldn't hold anyway.
Well, what's the matter with the engine?
Inlet valve's jammed. I'll have to release all the pressure before I can have a proper look. Then if I can fix it, I'll have to build it up again before we can go anywhere.
How long's that going to take?
A couple hours with a bit of luck.
In the meantime, we're drifting further out to sea.
Nothing much to worry about. No boats to drift into. We've got the radio if we need it. Reckon you should all relax and enjoy yourselves until I fix it.
Hey, what do you reckon, girls? Gonna get a suntan, eh?
Suits me just fine.
Oh, now this bloody thing won't work either.
I thought you said we needn't worry.
Still no big deal. I
Can't get the valves unstuck. It's better to let someone know we're out here.
But we were using the radio before and it worked.
Yeah, it'll receive all right, but I can't get a message out. Bloody thing.
But if we don't do something soon, we'll drift out through the heads.
Yeah, and get smashed to bits.
Right? An other ship sure to pass. Your officer's up on deck on lookout now.
Yeah, but what if we don't see no one?
Look, we've got distress flares as a last resort. I'm going to have another crack at the engines.
I'll give you a hand.
Well, I might take a wander up on deck myself.
No, Rita. That's just what you've been waiting for, isn't it? Joan up on deck alone with no witnesses?
You've been watching too many James Bond movies.
Did you break that radio as well?
Me? It's probably just the salt air.
And what about Miss Stout? Salt air knocked her overboard too, I suppose.
Hey, did you really do all that?
Yeah, and she sabotaged your engines, all to give her more time to have a go at Miss Ferguson.
Jeez, I know you want to get rid of her, but if we keep drifting, we'll all cark it.
Jeez, you're more of a bloody Nancy than she is. You're putting a lot of people in danger for your own selfish reasons.
Get stuffed. I do what I like, when I like it. Jeez, I wish I was back at Wentworth. Oh, will you stop clacking those bloody things in me ear hole?
You're so cranky just because you're losing.
Then rack off and let me concentrate.
Oh, no, Lexi, you've made me lose my place.
Are we playing cards here or having a women's auxiliary meeting?
Playing cards, give me one.
That'll have to do. I'm in for 10.
Don't you think you've played enough?
I'm on a winning streak.
Della takes 2.
I saw that.
What?
You cheated. You dealt from the bottom of the pack.
I never did.
Oh, there are witnesses here.
Looked all right to me.
Yeah, but you'll run the joint. Lorelei, you saw it, didn't you?
No, I was asked to move away.
I am telling you all, she cheated.
That's what Lurch said the other day when she was losing, and Rita backed me up. I run a fair game here, no cheating.
Crap! You tell them all you cheated! Let her run up, people! I bloody am. Why don't you keep your gorilla in the zoo where she belongs? Don't you call me a gorilla.
It's just a little thing inside a tummy that makes it do that.
It's all right, Merle. We'll go to the dorm now and read some comics.
What are you going to do about her cheek?
I'll sort it out when I get back. I don't want any more trouble.
Neither do we. Do we, Lex?
Vicky, open up the roulette wheel. If Patterson makes any more trouble, don't take a bet.
I'll be waiting for you, Maxwell. I don't like playing with cheats.
Sounds like you were having a bit of trouble.
We managed to sort it out.
Quiet as a churchyard around here.
Good.
I was real scared when I grabbed Lexi because I didn't want to hurt her baby.
Don't you worry about that. She's got to learn not to accuse people of cheating.
How many comics are you going to read me?
Oh, I think there might be time for quite a few. There's no hurry to get back to the casino, is there?
Goody.
Warning the others, would we?
Oh. Oh. Keep it rolling, you little mongrel! Woohoo! Oh, you won, Laurie! About bloody time, too. That's 36 washes you won, mate.
Thought I'd find you here, Patterson. You all know that gambling's not allowed.
Who's gambling?
We're just playing for washes.
Yeah, I don't see any money anywhere. Yeah, just a friendly little game to stop us getting bored, eh, girls?
I don't think the governor will agree when she sees all this. In fact, I'm sure she'll order a cell search. Then we'll see if there's any money involved.
I reckon the governor will want to know where you've been. You're supposed to be keeping an eye on me when I'm out of my cell, not snooping around.
I knew you were here all the time, and one more word out of you and you'll be on a charge for insolence.
Mr. Adams, I'm sure she didn't mean
that. I don't want any excuses from anyone, and no one's to leave this room till they're told.
By the time we got to shore, we could hardly see the ship. There's still no sign of them yet.
But you two are all right.
Yes.
Is Joan with them?
Yeah, and Mick.
Marty and Delia are all right, but the rest are out in the bay somewhere.
I've called the Coast Guard and the police and they're sending boats out. I'm sure they'll be all right.
Then why didn't they turn back?
I don't know. They just stopped. I think there must be something wrong with the engines.
I hope that's all it is.
Guess I should never have let Mick take it out.
Well, we'll talk about that later. I want you to look after yourself and Delia.
Okay, I'll call you in half an hour.
Just imagine the minister's reaction when he hears about this.
Please come in.
Take a few deep breaths and you'll feel better.
I tried that, but it just gave me the hiccups.
Good cup of tea will fix you up one way or the other.
Please come in.
You're wasting your time, lady. The radio's stuffed.
Surely there's something we can do.
There's no need to panic. Marty and Delia would have alerted the authorities by now. Someone will be sent to get us.
Oh, I'm going to be sick. Oh.
Get up on deck if you're going to chuck.
Downwind side of the boat.
I'm going, but hurry up and get us off this bloody thing.
Why don't you just fire a flare?
I'd rather wait till there's less light when it's more effective.
In the meantime, we just sit and twiddle our thumbs.
Well, there's nothing more we can do until it gets dark.
What's the hurry?
We won't get another chance to be alone like this.
It's rigged, of course. Whoever organised the whole operation is clever.
Ingenious.
They tried to tell me they weren't gambling, but what do you call
it?
Did you see
any money changing hands?
Well, no, but it's
you
obvious.
You can't charge anyone unless that can be proved.
We'll find it when we do the cell search, won't we, Mrs. Morris?
Wouldn't be the first time.
And the sooner the better.
Will you organise it, Meg?
Slow job with three officers missing.
Didn't you say Delia was on her way back?
Yes, but she may not be fit enough to continue her shift.
Well, what about Marty?
He's staying to help get the prisoners back as soon as possible. Safely, I hope.
I'm sure they'll be all right.
Just one of the things you risk when you allow prisoners out on work experience, I suppose.
Well, we don't know exactly what has happened yet.
So we'll delay the post-mortem till we do. You'd better organise the staff of the cell search, Rodney. I want to talk to Mrs. Morris.
Right away.
And don't start till Mrs. Morris is there.
Of course.
Really enjoys his work, doesn't he?
How many bloody times do I have to tell you?
We weren't playing for money, Mr. Adams.
We weren't even playing for bloody matchsticks.
It was just a game.
Of course it was. I believe in the Easter Bunny too.
He's getting worse than the freak.
I heard that, Patterson. One more word out of you and you'll be on a charge for insubordination.
Go on, sit down.
No, I've got to make sure he doesn't plant nothing. What the hell do you think you're doing?
There's no need to rush, Mr. Adams. A calm, orderly search is all that's required.
Yes, that's what I'm doing.
Do we really have to go through this? It's upsetting her.
I'm all right.
Look, it's not good for the baby.
Well, she's going to have to get used to it, isn't she? I mean, she's going to be born in here. Won't have any qualms about searching the cot, will we?
That's enough, Patterson.
It's not bloody right.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, I'm so glad you're here. I was going to ask you, do you think we could organise some maternity clothes for Lexi? You know how she likes to be up to date with fashion.
What are you suggesting?
Well, see, I've got this cousin. Well, he really isn't a cousin, but he makes the most gorgeous smocks and they're very reasonable.
Well, I think we can discuss it later.
I don't need any favours.
I'm not so sure about that, Patterson.
Much better up there either. Geez, we could drift for days. What if they never find us?
Oh, they will. Well, I'm beginning to understand what those poor boat people must have felt like.
Me too.
She'll be right. The Coast Guard cutter will be coming over that horizon any minute now.
I hope they never find us. Oh, they better come soon. Otherwise, we'll finish up in the South Pole and we get stuck in the ice like them explorer blokes did.
Don't worry, we'll bump into Tassie before we get that far.
Oh, yeah? Hey, I've got a cousin lives there. Maybe we could go and see her.
Look, if worse comes to worse, we could spend the night on the boat. We've got food and water and we could cook those flatheads you caught.
I only like fish the proper way. Frozen and out of a packet.
Suppose you've given up on that radio?
As a matter of fact, I was just about to try it again.
Where's Connors?
I think she's on deck, Miss Ferguson. I'll go and get her if
you... Stay where you are. Connors!
So you were in the Navy with Mr. Jackson?
That's right.
Did you like it?
Yeah. Helped me to grow up and appreciate the finer things of life.
Oh, such as?
Nice food, nice wine, nice people.
I thought that you sailors were supposed to have a girl in every port.
You don't want to believe everything you hear? I mean it.
God, I feel crooked. Do I have to do this?
Oh, it's better if you keep working, Alice. Takes your mind off it.
Do you know where Rita is?
Oh, geez, get off her back, Nan. She knows what she's doing.
That's exactly what I'm worried about. Mick, shouldn't there be somebody up in the wheelhouse?
No, she's right. We're in the channel. Can't come to any harm.
I can't stand it down here any longer. It's getting claustrophobic.
Nancy!
There's plenty of blankets on board in case we have to spend the night.
Yes, that's very reassuring. Now get back to work. What are you doing with that hammer, Connors?
Oh, Rita, we don't need that. We found another one downstairs.
Get below, the pair of you.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. I'm getting real sick of you getting in my way. What I do is my business. Stay out of it.
She's not worth it.
I'll decide that.
So, no casino, no gambling, no idea where the money came from. And the same goes for you, no idea. I see.
There's over $6 there, and Wilkinson's locker contained another...
Thank you, Mr. Adams. You've given me all the evidence I need. You can go back to your duties now.
Yes, Governor.
I think you both understand how disappointed I am in you. You'll both lose buy-up for 1 week. And I'm going to arrange for Patterson to be sent to isolation for the rest of her pregnancy.
But you can't do that! I didn't bloody do nothing!
Continuing to lie won't make things easier for you. Wilkinson, you can help Patterson pack up her things ready for the transfer.
Please, Mrs. Reynolds, you can't
Mrs.
do
Morris,
that!
Will you arrange for the appropriate furniture to be sent up to the cell? We'll make things as comfortable as possible for you.
I can't handle it up there by myself!
You should have thought of that before you deliberately ignored my instructions. You were not to go near the women unless there was an officer present.
But he bloody disappeared on me!
I don't want excuses.
Please, Mrs. Reynolds. Look, I'll take the blame for everything. But don't send her up there by herself. Think of the baby. They know when their mothers are unhappy, it gets them off to a very unhappy start in life.
I don't believe this is happening. I don't want to go.
We have a chair, please.
She's terribly sorry, Mrs. Reynolds. Can't you see that?
Now, calm down.
I couldn't handle it up there, Mrs. Reynolds. I couldn't handle it.
Patterson, you've just used up your last chance. Next time, you will be transferred.
Thank you, Mrs. Reynolds.
I don't want to be cruel. But I hope this has made you realize what you're risking if you don't cooperate a little.
You're right.
I have a responsibility to look after you and your baby, to protect you. I can't do either without your help.
You've had a very busy day, Mr. Adams.
Very busy. Very productive.
Mrs. Reynolds impressed?
Of course.
The girls appear to have lost quite a lot of money to you.
Well, lucky you and Merle didn't get caught up in it.
Nothing to do with luck.
No.
Good judgment.
And a quick mind. I admire that.
Thank you. I think I could probably provide you with more of the information you need if I could rely on your help with certain things as a sort of partner.
I'm not sure cooperating with prisoners is worth the risk.
You're not dealing with an ordinary jailbird here.
I'm beginning to realize that.
I learn very quickly. I'm sure you do too.
Go on.
I don't like taking risks any more than you do. Think about it.
Hi, Lurch. You still look a bit green about the gills.
Oh, jeez, I don't feel too good either.
Oh, shiver me timbers, you're not going to chuck again, are you?
Oh, I think it's the smell of that fish.
Well, get up on deck and aim it at Ferguson.
Oh, please don't have any more.
Don't you tell me
Rita,
what to do.
Rita, please.
I told you, stay out of it.
Hey, well, come on, you two. You'll have the freak down your hassle on us. Speak of the devil.
Oh, jeez, it's only you.
Thanks very much. And what are you lot up to now?
Oh. We thought you were the freak!
No, I've got better legs than she has.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
Oh, I see. You're all three sheets to the wind.
Just soaking up the duty freeze.
Yeah, but when Miss Ferguson finds out, she'll go crazy.
That would be reasonable under the circumstances. Can't wait to get you lot back to Wentworth.
Well, we're not there yet.
And the way this boat's drifting, it looks like we might never get this.
Just watch it, Connors.
I'm sick of the sound of your voice, Ferguson, so quit ordering me around.
You're only making things worse for yourself.
Now, cool down the pair of you.
You feel like a drink, Joan?
Rita.
Maybe we could go up deck and talk about it. The winner gets to go for a swim with the sharks. You're in trouble, Ferguson. And you know it.
We're all in trouble. Now, let me make one thing clear. Till things get back to normal, I say what goes in this boat. You'll do what I tell you. Understood?
Oh, it's fine by me, Cap. I've got all the time in the world.
I bet you one chocolate that I can make that black ball bounce off that red one, and then that red one will hit them four, and they're going to go in that hole, and that hole, and that hole, and that hole, all right? Magno the magic monkey taught me how to do this.
Oh.
Oh, nearly. I'll pay you back later, honest.
It's no good trying to get tough with me just because you've got an officer watching you every step.
I want my money back.
It's not our fault the screw sprung the game. I got done over too, remember?
I'm talking about the money you cheated me out of before Fancy Pants rolled in.
Bugger that, I wasn't cheat. Oh, bull!
Shh, Miss Ratcliffe can hear.
Cool it.
Come on, Lexi, will you forget about it? No way.
Laurie's right, Patterson.
Rita will be pleased when she finds out what's been going on.
The game is straight. Top. She saw that yesterday. Oh, you make me laugh. When you're winning, everything's fine. But as soon as you start losing, it's a completely different matter.
And Mrs. Morris, have you been able to be in touch with my cousin yet?
The goods will be delivered tomorrow.
Ah, oh, thank you. Hey, Mrs. M, how come Rita and the gang weren't back for tea?
Well, you're going to have to know sooner or later. They may not be back here tonight.
What's going on?
Just calm down and I'll explain. Now, they're probably all right.
Probably but... all right? What's that supposed to mean? I thought this thing was supposed to be safe.
Now, this probably isn't the best meal you've ever had, but I found a tin of sweet corn. The fish is delicious. Roach, would you like something?
No, I'm not hungry.
Oh, you should eat a little.
No, I can't. Sorry.
Right. Alice?
She reckons she's going to die.
How about you?
Why don't you offer Joanie some?
Miss Ferguson.
No, thank you, McCormick.
I'll have some. You're watching your figure.
It's a good idea, really.
Shut up and eat your food, Connors.
Temper, temper. Oh, Mick, would you like something to eat?
No, thanks. Bit busy at the moment.
Is there something happening up there?
No, but it's about time I send up another flare.
Will they still be looking for us at night?
Perhaps not.
That's a big gun you've got there, mister. You could do a lot of damage with that.
Certainly could. That's why it's kept under lock and key. Also, I'm going to have to turn the deck lights off, otherwise it'll drain the battery. So I don't want anyone up on deck unless I'm with them. It's too dangerous.
No, we don't want no accidents. We'll never find your body if you went overboard on a night like this.
You need to go up top. You just let me know. I'll make sure you'll be all right.
Perfectly happy right where I am.
Fair enough.
Your written reports can wait till the morning. Are you sure that when Connor slipped and knocked you off balance, it was an accident?
Oh, yes.
And Miss Ferguson didn't see it?
No.
Had there been any problems between her and the women during the morning?
Well, she was showing her usual amount of professional detachment with them, but that's normal.
Yes.
Will there be any trouble about the boat going out for a run?
It could be repercussions. I'll have to wait and see what Miss Ferguson has to say about that.
I can't believe a boat that size can just have disappeared.
The Coast Guard were great. They'll be back on the job at first light.
Let's hope the weather holds. I think you should both go home and get some rest.
I'd rather wait, just in case there is any news.
Me too.
Yes, all right.
Maybe they're stuck in a shipwreck like Dr. Zargo and the Moon Creatures. Maybe they're stuck in a sea of that sticky stuff.
Maybe they are.
Ah, just remembered.
What?
I've got to give Jacko a lolly for losing a bet.
You can see her tomorrow.
Nah. She might want to eat it now. I've got to be honest, like you said.
No.
Looney Tunes, that'll be right.
I think you'll pardon.
Oh, yeah, all right. Hey, it's a bit of good news about the beetle and the cronies, eh? You reckon they'll be back?
Well, it's got to be better for us without them.
True.
It's going to be so much easier to take money off these mugs if they've carked it.
You should be in your own cell, McPherson.
Yeah, keep your thatch on. Just go on.
Where's Jones?
In the toilet.
I've been thinking about your offer. You realise I'm not interested in your money.
What money?
Look, I know you made a packet out of the casino. I'm just beginning to realise how clever you are. Not that I don't admire a little enterprise.
I just use a little common sense, that's all, Mr. Adams. It seems to be something women forget about when they're in prison.
Well, anyway, I'm not interested in your money, and I'm not interested in your information.
What are you interested in?
I'll give her it.
You're late for lockup, Jones.
Am I? What did he want?
Well, I'm not too sure, Mel. But I think I've got a pretty good idea.
Oh, at least back at Wentworth I could get a bloody aspirin.
If you asked nicely.
Perhaps a cup of tea would help.
I'll get it. What's the matter with you, kid?
Nothing.
We're waiting for fairies, are we?
No, I'm not.
Are you any better? I'll get the blankets.
Where are you going to sleep tonight?
In the wheelhouse. Don't worry, these bunks are pretty comfortable if you organise yourself properly.
Oh, no. I wish it had stopped. Oh, I'm going to be sick. I'm going to get a bucket or something.
Come on, honey. We're going to get you up on deck for some fresh air.
I'll come too. Let me help.
It's the only thing that'll cure her.
Me too.
Yeah, but just keep well away from the sides.
Don't see you offering to help Ferguson. That's not like you.
I'll deal with you when we get back to Wentworth, Connors.
I've got this feeling we're not going back.
You make me sick.
Yes, I'm sick. I'm sick of you. Do you know what Slasher once said to me? He said, never trust scum that are too scared to laugh when they're happy or cry when they're sad. Yeah, my Slasher said that. He was a big, rough, tough, rowdy bugger, and he could smell an evil bastard 10 miles away. Well, he's dead, and I'll never forget him. And I'll never forget what mongrel killed him either.
Well, that's the last of the search and rescue vessels in. We won't hear anything till the morning, and you both look as though you need a good night's rest.
I don't think I'll be able to sleep tonight for thinking of them.
I know how you feel, but you must try.
Well, thanks for being so understanding.
That's for me too.
I'll see you both in the morning, or I'll call you if I hear any news.
Okay. Nine.
It's amazing.
Yeah, that's true.
I should thank you too.
Come on, you didn't need me to swim to that beach.
Maybe not, but I wish I could tell you how I really felt when I realised you jumped in to save me. I mean, you...
Hey, come on. Everything's fine.
No, it's not.
Look, I'm sure the governor, she'll be reasonable about it.
It's all my fault. I was slacking. Oh, come on, you know it. Mrs. Reynolds knows it. Everyone knows
it. You're imagining things.
No, I'm not.
Well, I was slacking too. I shouldn't have been in that wheelhouse. Maybe we've both blown it. Come on.
Just let me know if you need anything.
I need to die.
5 beds and only 4 bunks. I wonder who's going to sleep sitting up.
I was thinking of spending the night up in the wheelhouse to keep me company.
You'll do no such thing.
You wouldn't be pushing around one of my pals, would you?
She'll spend a month in solitary if she goes up there.
I reckon it's a free world right now. Go for it, Roach.
Waters?
Go on, Roach. Don't you ever get sick of the sound of your own voice? She's doing you a favour. Now you've got a nice bunk to sleep in.
I'm quite comfortable where I am.
Please yourself.
I think we should all try and get some sleep.
Leave that on, Connors.
Oh, don't tell me you're scared of the dark.
The light stays on.
You heard what Mick said about the batteries?
Leave it!
You are not in charge here anymore. I'll tell you what, I'll meet you halfway. That's that sorted out.
I can wait, Connors.
So can I.
You all right?
Yeah, just can't sleep.
No. Nor can I.
What do you reckon could have happened to him?
It's not an escape plan. Not after Rita dragged Roach in the other day. It wouldn't make any sense.
Yeah, suppose. But, I mean, if they can't find the boat, it could have gone down.
Mrs. Morris is certain I'll find them in the morning.
What would she bloody know? They could all be dead.
Oh, don't even think about it, Lexi. They'll be all right. Come on, darling, you need your sleep.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Oh. Ow!
What's the matter?
She kicked me!
Who?
She did, he did, well, it did, but whatever it bloody is, it kicked me.
Baby?
Yeah, it's the first time I've felt it that strong.
She's just letting you know who's boss.
It's all right, mate. Go back to sleep, eh? I've got the message.
For you, Miss Ferguson.
Everything all right down here?
Yeah, having a real ball.
Any sign of the Coast Guard or the police?
Not yet, but we've drifted near land. You'd better come and have a look.
Well, we just might be closer to Wentworth than we thought. Oh. Well, your little picnic's well and truly over, Waters.
Don't get stuck into her.
You lot amaze me, you really do. I'm going to see they throw the book at you. At the very least, you lose your ticket, boy.
Look, you.
Don't waste your breath.
The rest of you have had your last laugh for quite a while, too. It's going to take the governor about a month to read all these charges. Now get below and clean the sleeping quarters and report back here. Well, Connors, now that we know what we really think of one another, we're going to get along just fine.
You gonna come and visit me?
I might not have to. I wouldn't get too upset if I were you. We've drifted a lot further than I thought we had. There's land all right, but we're a hell of a long way from civilization.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing